Welcome back to LovieTech. The new RTX 4070 Ti just launched few days ago. But see the price about 800 bucks? Is it really worth to buy that graphic card? The previous RTX 3070 Ti cost about 600 bucks. But Nvidia increased the new 70 Ti price about 33%. So that's 200 bucks extra is quite a huge impact for a budget user. Last time, I sold my 3080 Ti because I need pay house deposit. And now I need a good enough card for benchmarking. So, instead buying a new 4070 Ti, I decided to look around the second-hand market and I found this RTX 3080 Ti. If you see the performance of the RTX 3080 Ti versus 4070 Ti, it's not much difference, but this second-hand RTX 3080 Ti costs only 540 bucks. And 4070 Ti in my place not cost about 800 bucks. In my place, there is a tax for about 18.5%. That's outside the shipping and also the model variation. So the lowest price you can find is 800 bucks plus 18.5% tax. While you can find the second-hand 3080 Ti only for about 540 bucks. Compared to RTX 4070 Ti, 3080 Ti performance is not so far. From hardware unboxed video, 3080 Ti is about 8% slower than 4070 Ti in 4K gaming. While in 1440p gaming, 3080 Ti is 13% slower than 4070 Ti. From the performance difference with 4070 Ti, 3080 Ti is not really bad deal. Well, if you want to buy the used market of 30 series GPU, you need to consider that most of 30 series GPU is already used for mining purpose. You should avoid DDR6X non-low hash rate cards. Example RTX 3090 and old RTX 3080. Both using GDDR6X and overclock during mining. And some of the VRAM reach more than 100 degrees Celsius when mining. And also, not all 3080 Ti is in good condition. So if you want to buy, you need to ask seller to test the card properly. You need to check the temperature. Also, the most important is memory temperature. Don't forget to check the display also. If all okay, then you can buy it. And it's better if the card still have warranty. Like the one I bought here, it's still covered by NVIDIA International Warranty. So, if something happened with my card, I still can contact NVIDIA to have replacement. There are 4 advantages of buying 4070 Ti instead of this 3080 Ti. The first is power draw. 4070 Ti has less 70 watt power draw than this 3080 Ti. However, you still can undervolt your 3080 Ti to match the 4070 Ti power draw. The second is 3080 Ti doesn't have AV1 encoder. It only have AV1 decoder. So, if you want to use the AV1 encoder, it's better to buy the latest 4070 Ti or you still can put like cheap Intel GPU in your second GPU slot and you will get an AV1 encoder. The third advantage of 4070 Ti is the killer cooler. The cooler designed to cool down the 4090. However, the manufacturer just put on 4070 Ti which is overkill, and because of that cooler, 4070 Ti have very low temperature compared to 3080 Ti. Well, you can see my 3080 Ti only have 2.3 slot. It's much thinner than 3 slot 4070 Ti lowest model. And the last advantage of 4070 Ti is DLSS 3. You know that only 40 series can use frame generator. However, few months ago, AMD announced about FSR 3. And that FSR 3 is embedded in Unreal Engine 5. So it's still possible that FSR3 will work in another device other than RDNA3. So we need to wait until FSR3 launch and it's either work only RDNA3 or another card. If it can work with another card, example like my 3080 Ti, there is no reason for you buying overpriced 40 series GPU. Well, the frame generator have big impact of the latency. It double latency than the normal usage. If you playing the competitive game, you can use the normal FSR of DLSS. So you no need to concern about DLSS3. You can just buy like my 3080 Ti or other 30 series. Okay, that's all from me. If you like this video, please press like and subscribe. And don't forget to check the link in the description below. Thanks for watching.